As we all know it, the last 1 year has seen tectonic shifts across different sectors, different parts of the economy, and tech and social media have been in the center of all the action, of all the disruptions that the various sectors and businesses have gone through. Joining me today is Arun Srinivas, the Director of Global Business Group at Facebook India. Thank you so much for taking time out to chat with us today and to talk about how things have evolved, how the trends are evolving in the industry, how businesses have warmed up to the idea of going completely online, and not just going online, but actually promoting themselves and scaling up on that medium. Thank you, Arun. Well, for starters, I want to understand how the past 15 odd months have been for you guys, and what are the key trends you've seen for both traditional businesses and for new businesses with respect to moving completely online or moving to social media post COVID.
Yeah, I think in some sense you've stolen the words with your intro. I think it's been a tectonic shift. You know, so we've seen actually digital acceleration in India, post pandemic, almost move at a pace which is possibly 2-3 years ahead in normal times. So, you know, I think it's got consumers and every one of us to really look at digital ways of, you know, transacting their lives, right? So whether it is grocery, whether it is medicines, you know, whether it is even gym classes, you know, people are obviously looking online to really saying, you know, how can I continue doing what I do, you know, but using digital as the forefront. So in that sense, you know, therefore, Indians have taken to this, and obviously it's no surprise that we are the largest consumers of gigabytes on a per capita basis in the world, right? And within that, of course, video content is large, and I'll come to that separately. But therefore, in the last 15 months, you know, businesses, small, medium, large, everyone has really shifted. And, you know, what we've seen, I would say, is initially it was like shift to digital marketing spends, if I were to use that word, you know, where people moved monies maybe between traditional and digital marketing channels really to reach their messages through the digital medium, you know, because obviously of either it being cost effective at that point of time, you know, or equally reaching specific cohorts. But now what we are seeing, you know, especially post the second wave, is that I would say companies are really gearing to shift their business models completely to digital.
Given the host of disruptions that are taking place, especially in the online tech space, in the social media, various platforms, you have a bouquet of offerings, whether it's Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp. Can you tell us, how are your users making the most of it? How exactly can they sort of make the most of it and really do something on their own without investing too much money? Because, of course, social media gives you an immense and, you know, unthinkable amount of reach. So how can they use it to their benefit?
If I look at Instagram today, for example, you know, it has really 3 to 4 constituents, right? You know, who really comprise the platform. Firstly, there is the, members of the public who obviously log in and check out Instagram every day. Secondly, we have celebrities or creators, as we call them, you know, so you could, you know, and you, you know, these are really, let's say, popular celebrities like Virat, for example, who's one of the most followed celebrities in India. Or equally, it could be a creator, you know, who is just starting off, with her own recipes in terms of, let's say, what to cook as interesting snacks for children, you know, because that's also an interesting theme in these times because you're largely confined to your home again. And whether it is for each of them, celebrities or creators, and we have, of course, the members of the audiences, then you have businesses, you know, so somewhere, you know, you have this triangle between these three, and that's really what, Instagram is. So how do you really bring businesses, creators and celebrities and audiences together? What I think the platform allows you to do is to really go after a specific audience, no matter how small or how big, depending on who you are, right? So today you're starting off a completely new business in fashion or let's say makeup. You can actually decide to really target only a certain age segment or a certain, demographic segment, saying living only in Mumbai or only in Delhi, for example, you know, and really reach them. Or equally, if you're a mom chef, you know, who really wants to start a business, you can again do the same. So I think People can obviously post content, you know, find a way to link with, you know, their consumers. And obviously, the more interesting the content is, definitely the more followership we get. Reels is, again, for example, one statistic I can share is that in the last 3 months, 6 million reels are produced in India alone every day. So you can imagine the hordes of content which, you know, literally every one of us is really putting out there. Who are confident to put it out there and obviously build a followership. So it's a great time to really be a creator.
And what is Facebook's contribution to that? I mean, how are you helping brands or individuals customize their content?
Yeah, so I think, one is we really stand for two parts, right? Our platform, as I said, the ethos is in really building, bringing firstly the creators on board in making sure, for example, we have, separate, I'd say, training sessions, etc., on what works, what doesn't work. You know, we really reach out to each of these creators, you know, and there are lots of self-serve tools as well, you know, which help them in terms of posting right content. They can even access stuff and metrics like, you know, for each video, for example, what the feedback was in terms of clicks, likes, full, view throughs and plays, etc. So that gives you, I'd say if you are a creator, for example, putting up, let's assume 30 videos of 30 recipes, you will know which worked, which didn't work. You know, that's for you to then introspect and figure out what worked. Is it, what is it really, the recipe or the shots? You know, so you almost also you're able to get the comments immediately, you know, and you, I'm sure you will look at this and then, you know, keep refining content. So that's one thing which we offer. On the other side, what we do with brands is that, today, for example, if I take a, you know, any brand, you know, in any space, let's say a soap or a shampoo or a toothpaste, for example, there is a main message, you know, that obviously, this brand helps you kill germs or prevents cavities. Now, how do you still land that to a digital first audience in a unique and interesting way? So you obviously, there are firstly, I think, multiple lessons for brands here, right? Because every medium is different. We don't obviously put the same 30-seconder TVC, you know, onto print. You know, we have a different message for print. You render it for print. Or equally, you have a eye-catching outdoor, you know, which you want people to really stop by as they drive through, you know, to really make sure that you land the main message. So in digital, it's very similar, right? So we have a multitude of formats across our platforms. So whether I look at, for example, Reels is a different platform within Instagram from Stories, right? And each of them have obviously hundreds of millions of people, logging in every day. So I think what we work with brands is to really make sure that they are able to understand the platform, develop the right content.
Different offerings that you just talked about, are they equally accessible across age demographics or perhaps region-wise? Because while a person sitting in a Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore may be able to access it easily and, you know, make the most of it, how can people perhaps in tier three or in the hinterlands could also use the same medium to reach out to people?
No, today, firstly, I think it's, Facebook as a, family of apps, today we reach over 400 million people, and between Facebook, WhatsApp and Instagram today, clearly we are almost the census of India's internet. Most of the content that I spoke about today of the 6 million reels, for example, that's put out every day, a large part of that is vernacular. So we see a lot more creators coming on board, from small towns across the length and breadth of this country, you know, putting up videos in Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Gujarati, whatever, right? So in that sense, I think it's a true democratic platform. People are quick to understand that this is something that they can build and create followership, you know, and set goals for themselves as creators or for their own small business.
You know, we have to talk about Reels. You just said that you recently completed a year in India. Can you tell us how it has grown among users in terms of accessibility as well as provided a medium for brands, for individuals to sort of communicate their message in an efficient, exciting and interesting way?
Yeah, I think, firstly, as I said, India is, India loves video. And within that, short form video is obviously, really rapidly growing trend, not just here, across the globe. For brands, I think, we see a huge advantage for them to jump onto the Reels bandwagon. The reason is because, unlike, let's say, regular Instagram, where you are only served who you follow, Here, I think in with Reels, you are also able to go to the Reels tab and search for content. And, you know, that allows you to discover lots more brands and creators.
You know, since I have you here with us, I would like you to simply tell us or give us some tips about how can the average user make money from a platform like Reels? Because that's what our audience wants to know. How about, you know, creating wealth or making most of any platform that they have access to? So if you could simplify that and tell us how can they make the most of it and expand their business or make more money?
See, I think, again, whether it is for an individual, you know, and our parlance, we call it a creator, you know. So let's say an individual creator here or a small business, you know, let's say who's in the business of, you know, financial planning and stuff like that. They can certainly look at building who they are and what they stand for, you know, through a series of reels. So my advice would be whoever you are, as long as you're authentic, you know, and you find a way to really build credible stories around you, you will soon definitely build a followership. I don't see that. I mean, I've seen this personally with many other creators we've been associated with, be it chefs, makeup artists, etc. So I think just, you know, being confident of who you are, putting out that content organically, you know, you will start getting feedback, and I'm sure you will reflect on that, keep improvising till you achieve a, you know, certain equilibrium. And that's really how I would encourage someone to do this, you know. And even for a small business, let's say if I'm very specialized in managing only certain parts of financial investments, I can really put out, you know, who I am and who I stand for, and really target, I think, specifically only those cohorts of users, you know, rather than everyone in the country.
Can you also throw some light on how, you know, these influencers or these potential influencers can actually make money or monetize their efforts?
So we bring the creators and the brands together. So when we post it out as a branded content tag, you know, clearly, because this is almost like influencer marketing. That's the right word, right? So you're leveraging creators to really become influencers so that they inspire their followers to evaluate or consider this brand. So they certainly make money in this process. You know, in fact, I would say that most of the money is made by them in the process, you know, versus the platform. So we are an intermediary which brings the creators, you know, and the brands together. And I think our strength is also in able to identify and work with the brands on who the right creators could be basis who they want to target. So for example, if I'm a brand and I want to target now only, let's assume, somebody in the state of Andhra Pradesh for makeup. So I need to figure out who the right makeup creators are, you know, who can obviously convince the Telugu speaking audiences, you know, and really build, you know, my cause there. So we are a platform that really bridges, you know, brings them together, you know, which is a divided world in terms of unifying them on our platform. That's really what we do. And Instagram really is, you know, I think our purpose is really to bring these communities together, be it the creator community, as I call them, even a celebrity is a creator, you know, the audiences and the brands together. So that's really what, you know, I think our strength is.
Okay. On that note, Arun, thank you so much for taking time out to chat with us and help our audiences also understand how, you know, the social media works and how they can leverage it to grow their brand or, you know, as individuals and as creators on this particular platform. Thank you once again.
Thanks, Karunya. Pleasure talking to you.